iodine today is more important than it ever has been, and yet we know it's always been important. Iodine is the oldest allopathic medicine. It's the first medicine, actually, that cured a specific disease, which is goiter. The governments around the world 50 years ago recognized how important it was and started putting iodine in salt. And even in the United States, it was put in the bread. And then some crazy person took it out from the government and put bromide in its place. So, iodine is very important for the body, for health. The Japanese eat a lot of more iodine than anybody else because of the high consumption of seafood. There are several doctors in the world. I call them the iodine doctors. Dr. David Brownstein is a friend of mine, and he's written a book on iodine and inspired me to write a book on iodine. And I subtitled it Bringing Back the Universal Medicine because it is very useful for many, many things. It's essential. We need it. We need it. The thyroid needs iodine to produce thyroid hormone, which controls the metabolism of the cells. So it's a very fundamental substance. It has been used forever in hospitals and emergency rooms as a topical substance to kill viruses, bacteria, fungus, mold, mildew. It basically kills all single-cell pathogens very quickly. So I use it instead of antibiotics. Only once in all these years have I used antibiotic in desperation for one of my children, and I have six children. Whenever they get sick, the first thing I go for is the iodine, the second thing I go for is the magnesium, and the third thing I go for is the sodium bicarbonate. When dealing with flu, these substances, or cold, or anything that moves the body into discomfort, the beginning of any disease, the beginning of anything, these substances used very quickly can, you can have a cold, start with a cold, and really avoid going deeply into it. Same with the flu. If you use magnesium chloride orally strongly, the bicarbonate and the iodine orally, you can kind of head off a flu or cold at the pass. That's how effective these substances are. If they can save a life from a person from a heart attack or magnesium, if you inject it quick enough, when a person's having a stroke, they can avoid all the brain damage. So iodine is important and can be used in cancer treatment. Dr. Tullio Simoncini has pioneered the use of iodine topically for skin cancer. He was not aware, though, that you could really take it orally in high dosages and actually treat cancer internally, because the iodine will be on a seek and destroy mission of anything that doesn't belong in the body. It's a broad-spectrum killer of pathogens. Some people believe that cancer is a fungus. And there are a lot of good reasons to see and believe that. Or, if you disagree with that, to recognize that cancer is usually or very often accompanied by infectious process. And late-stage infections tend to be fungus. Sodium bicarbonate is a very strong antifungal, and so is iodine.